I'm sorry, sir, I can't hear you.
So I had a new wing built on the building, had AC, new bed, everything ready to go. I had another final inspection of the old building. We had a problem, electric, AC went down. Called ACA, well, they're in a meeting. I said, you talk to somebody, I think you do need to be. Well, we can't interrupt them, they're in a meeting. Now, this is not your hurry. Okay, there's a little problem. And I called more halls, I said, well, I'm moving now. Well, I can't give you authorization, I'll just be receptive. Okay. I get a call later in the afternoon, ask me what's going on, I told them, I said, moving over to our new wing. And they're doing fine, you got AC. Well, we're gonna have some light on investigating that, don't you ever do that again, our commission. But they were busy in a meeting, ACA.
And that is an experience that I don't think that Hollywood Hills was alone in this, just as you're pointing out. And I appreciate your plight that you went through and taking care of your residents. And I know everybody in this room was dedicated to taking care of their residents on these days. What we all found ourselves in the wake of to start with, including what you were just sharing, and I appreciate that, was false promises and a reasonable reliance on those promises. You know, there are a number of experts involved in this. We have experts assembled from every specialty, from administration to nursing to regulatory to the folks that actually literally wrote the book on heat and humidity and the effects on the elderly. These are the folks, this is the information and the resource that we have now that nobody in this room had access to then. But that said, what do we know? This is Mr. Devereaux speaking in terms of the governor and his promises, and I'm sure you all were on those calls where he gave his cell phone number out.
Then this is the administrator expert.
Yeah, this is the administrator expert. I have not ever seen, in almost 40 years of nursing home experience, a governor give out a personal cell phone number and say, call me. I think we can both agree that that's a little extraordinary. That in and of itself can become problematic if not managed effectively. This is the ACA attorney. What do you mean by problematic if not managed effectively? Well, some people are going to believe it. He goes on, I think it can create an unreasonable expectation that the governor is going to hug the nursing home industry and resolve these issues. It doesn't relieve the responsibility to take care of patients every day, but you have to admit it does make somebody believe, if I call you, they will come. Kind of like the Field of Dreams. And in this case, they did call and call and call again, and nobody came, and they did. Records released by the governor's office show more than 150 calls were made to Rick Scott's personal cell phone while approached on Saturday the 9th through Tuesday. Included were four calls from Natasha Anderson, an administrator at Clark Behavioral Health Services that was adjacent to, connected into the same building as Rehab Center of Hollywood Hills.
And our governor deleted those voicemails, of course.
All voicemails were deleted. Deleted. We had the same experiences that we just shared. We had assisted living. An assisted living facility full of elderly patients has been without power since Sunday, despite repeated calls for assistance, the executive director said late Wednesday. This is the same time period we're talking about when these folks started passing away. The Stone Ledge Manor Assisted Living and Memory Care Center housed 58 residents that has had difficulty keeping them cool. We have no power, we have no air conditioning. We have dark hallways, I have family bringing in generators. And the response from the governor's office and others, utility companies and local governments, determined the order of power restoration. The governor's office said in a statement late Wednesday, we have been in constant contact with hospitals, nursing homes, and assisted living facilities to make sure that everyone is safe. We've dispatched the Department of Health and law enforcement has responded to help these individuals. Safety is the governor's top priority, and all healthcare facilities must do everything possible to ensure the health, safety, and well-being of those in care. We just had a bill die in committee that would prioritize assisted living and nursing homes for power utility response.
Representative Sean Harrison had a bill that was introduced, and it died in committee, and I asked, and Sean's a personal friend of ours, we asked Representative Harrison what happened, and he said, this Plain and simple, utility lobby. That's it.
Yes, ma'am.
I've been fighting the battle for a lot of years. Back in the pre-hurricane season, I had a building that we had no power, and I was literally sending residents out to emergency rooms just to cool down because they were blocking. And we called and called. And I finally called the governor's office, who was not the state governor, but governor's office, like, oh, my state representatives, who did call.
So you got satisfaction after you called your representative?
Yes, but not from the governor's.
Right. So yeah, but I know the rain is kind of making it a little harder here. But she said the governor's was years ago, though, right?
This was in the pre-hurricane season. Here we have the pre-hurricane.
Okay, 2004.
Yes, right. Right. And I happen to know because I was working with Sue Garcia. She lost her job, and that's like she did everything she can. A really good person.
Yeah, she. She called the governor's office in 2004, got no satisfaction, called her state representative, who got on the board and rattled some pages, and the power company came out, and it was a little switch to get her back on the board.
So what do we know? We have an approved CEMP. Broward County approved, in place, followed. We had an Alpha Bravo staffing in place. We had folks dedicated and in this building, sleeping there for days and then being refreshed by the Bravo team. And the management is there making sure that they get activated. Hydration rounds, our caregivers, dedicated, educated, experienced individuals. Spot coolers, every resident had a fan in their room. And we had these big mama fans in addition to the spot coolers. They lowered the air temp before the chiller was hit. So the air in the building was taken down into the 70s.
And the air, what happened was the transformer was hit by lightning that powered the air conditioner, so you put the generator, that's why the air conditioner did not work. And as it turned out, that was about a 20-minute fix by FPL.
When they finally came out,
yes,
sir. Well, I can tell you this. The ME found that a 99-year-old hospice resident who was on 24/7 crisis care management with a hospice caregiver directly with her, they ruled that the ME said that was a homicide.
Oh, God.